This lecture is continuation with the unit 3. Our next topic is IP address and its versions. Like, let's first understand what is IP address. IP address an IP address is a number identifying of a computer or another device in the internet. That means IP address क्या एक ऐसा number है जो कि हमारे computers and other devices को internet में find करने में मदद करता है. For example, अगर मैं IP address को real life से relate करूँ तो जो जैसे कि हमारा mail address होता है वैसे ही IP address होता है. Mail address पे क्या होता है, हमारे जितने भी mails आने होते हैं, जितने भी कोई भी data हमें कोई transfer करता है तो वो हमें receive होते हैं. Same as नेटवर्क में हर डिवाइस का एक आईपी एड्रेस होता है जिसके थ्रू हम उससे डेटा एक्सचेंज कर सकते हैं या कोई भी इंफॉर्मेशन एक्सचेंज कर सकते हैं. आईपी एड्रेस के जनरली टू पार्ट्स होते हैं, एक तो होस्ट आईडी होती है, उसमें एक होती है नेटवर्क आईडी. अब कौन सा पार्ट नेटवर्क आईडी रिप्रेजेंट करेगा, कौन सा पार्ट होस्ट आईडी रिप्रेजेंट करेगा, ये डिपेंड करता है क्लासेस पर. आईपी एड्रेस की बहुत सारी क्लासेस हैं जो हम आगे पढ़ने वाले हैं. नेक्स्ट हम यहाँ पर पढ़ रहे हैं IPv4. IPv मतलब इंटरनेट प्रोटोकॉल वर्जन 4, तो उसी की डिटेल के बारे में हम यहाँ पर बात करेंगे. तो इसका जो नंबर ऑफ बिट्स यूज करता है IPv4 वो है 32 बिट्स. दैट मीन्स इट अलाउज टू पावर 32 यूनिक एड्रेसेस. जनरली वी रिप्रेजेंट दिस एड्रेस बाय 4 बाइट्स. वी सेपरेट दीज बिट्स बाय इन 4 ब्लॉक्स, राइट. तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव एन आई पी एड्रेस 168.212.226.204. दिस इज द डेसिमल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ अ आई पी एड्रेस एंड इट्स बाइनरी रिप्रेजेंटेशन इज हेयर इन द रेड. नेक्स्ट वी कंसिडर वॉट इज सबनेट मास्क. सबनेट मास्क डिफाइंस विच पार्ट ऑफ द एड्रेस विल बी द एड्रेस ऑफ द नेटवर्क एंड विच पार्ट विल बी द होस्ट, राइट. कंटिन्यूस नंबर ऑफ 1 रिप्रेजेंट्स द सबनेट मास्क. Let's now discuss the classes of the IP address. 5 main classes we have, class A, B, C, D and E. Now we'll discuss what these classes are. Class A, in class A we have 8 bits for the network ID and 24 bits for the host ID. Class A is generally used for the large networks where we have large number of hosts, right. Then we have total number of networks here is 2^7, which comes from the total number of network bits minus 1. Because 1 bit in class A is reserved, that is 0. I'll show you later in the diagram. And total number of addresses we can define over is 2^31. And its range start from 1 to 126. Its subnet mask is 255.0.0.0. And address 127 is reserved for the loopback address. Next. Class B. In class B, we have 16 number of bits for the network ID and 16 bits for the host ID. It is assigned for the medium size network and its range is from 128 to 191. Its subnet mask is 255.255.0.0. Next, we have class C. In class C, we have 28 bits for the network ID and 8 bits for the host ID. Class C is assigned to the smaller networks and its range is from the 192 to 223. Its subnet mask is 255.255.255.0. Next is class D. Class D is for the multicasting. In the previous lecture, we have understood what is multicasting. And in class D, 4 bits are reserved that are 111 and 0. These are fixed bits. Then the remaining bits are used for the network and the subs. And so on, right. Its ranges start from 224 to 239. It do not have any subnet mask. Next, class E is reserved for the experimental and the research purposes. Its range is from the 242 to 255, right. And it also do not have any subnet mask. These are the 5 main classes of the IP address. This is the diagram which I was talking about, like how which bits are reserved already in the IP address. Like in class A, first bit is reserved 0 and the remaining 7 bits can be filled with the network ID and the remaining bits with the host ID. So on in class B, 10, these are the fixed bits which are written in the blue portion. Next we will discuss the IPv4 header. Header is the extra information which is included before transmitting the data to the next layer, right. So basic header is consist of, like, first part in header is version, which Next is header length, type of services, total length, identification. These are the flag bits, fragment offset, time to look, protocol, header checksum, IP address, destination address, option, and then comes the data. Let's discuss in detail what are these. First version, like we are talking here about IPv4, that means that the 4 in the end represents the version of the protocol. So it is 4 bits field, and we here we will write 4, right? Next is header length. Header length is IP header length is of 4 bit. It contains the IP address. It helps in knowing from where the actual data begins, right? Total complete header length यहाँ पर हमारी आएगी और इसके रेंज क्या है 20 bytes to 60 bytes. Types of services, this is generally the QoS quality of service which it is following, and it is of the 8 bits. Total length is of the header length plus data which is to be transmitted. Like it is of 16 bits. Next is identification. Identification is used for the purpose of identifying the various fragments, right? So हम क्या करते हैं कि जितने भी हमारे फ्रेगमेंट होते हैं उनको एक यूनिक आईडी असाइन कर देते हैं ताकि हमें पता चल जाए कि कौन सा पार्ट किस डेटा का है. इसके लिए कितने बिट्स असाइन किए गए हैं? 16 बिट्स. नेक्स्ट फ्लैग बिट्स, बेसिकली वी हैव 3 फ्लैग बिट्स. फर्स्ट इज 0 विच इज रिजर्व विच इज फिक्स. नेक्स्ट इज डू फ्रेगमेंट फ्लैग बिट, एंड नेक्स्ट इज मोर फ्रेगमेंट्स फ्लैग बिट. दीज बिट्स आर सेट टू बी एज 0 और 1 depending upon the condition. Do fragment if set is 0, that means we cannot fragment it further. If it is set to 1, that means we can fragment it further. More fragment if it is considered, if it is filled with 0, that means it is the last fragment of the data and no further fragments are available in the network. If it is set to be 1, that means it is not the last, some more fragments are also available for that particular data. Next is fragment offset. Fragment offset defines the original position of the fragmented data in the unfragmented portion. Next is time to live. Time to live generally is defined so that we can stop the overlooping of the packet in the network. That means जो भी हमारा packet होता है, क्या होता है कभी कभार network में rotate करता रहता है, तो क्या होता है ये क्या कहते हैं कंजेशन प्रॉब्लम क्रिएट कर देता है. इसलिए क्या करते हैं हमारा जो भी पैकेट होता है हम उसके लिए एक टाइम टू लिव डिसाइड कर देते हैं. जैसे क्या होता है वो पैकेट हमारा एक होप से दूसरे होप पर ट्रेवल करता है तो हमारा टाइम क्या होता है डिक्रीज होता जाता है. एक ये काउंटर की तरह काम करता है. जैसे ये 0 पर रीच हो जाता है हम क्या अगर वो डेस्टिनेशन तक नहीं पहुँच पाता हम क्या कर देते हैं इसको डिस्कार्ड कर देते हैं. नेक्स्ट इज प्रोटोकॉल. It tells the network layer at the destination host to which protocol the IP address belong to. That means जो भी sender ने packet भेजा है वो क्या protocols use कर रहा है वो हम यहाँ पर define करते हैं. इसके लिए 8 bits fix है हमारे. Next is header checksum which is of 16 bits which helps us in errors checking. Then next is source IP address which is of 32 bits. It is the address of the sender. Next is destination IP address which is 32 bits and it is the IP address of the receiver. Next is optional field which provide the optional information like source route, record route and the padding information. This completes our IPv4 version. Next is IPv6 which is the updated version of the internet protocol. It is 128 bits. Like we can define 2 power 128 addresses here. Like in the IPv4, we divide our address into the 4 groups. Here we divide our address into the 8 groups, each representing 2 bytes. Next, the same like we have studied for the IPv4 that header, same here. We have some different fields over here. Version, priority traffic. Traffic class, flow label, payload length, next header, hop limit, source address, destination address and extension header. Let's discuss them in the detail. Version, as I told you, which version it is following, like here we are talking about IPv6, that means that field will contain the value 6. It is of 4 bits. Next is traffic class, that means it defines the type of service which it is using, like class of the packet and also the priority. It is of the 8 bits. Next is flow label. Flow label, the purpose of the flow label is to indicate that this packet belongs to a specific sequence of packet between the source and destination and cannot be and can be used to prioritize delivery of the packet. That means hum iske through ye pata kar sakte hain ki jo packet hai hamari uski kya priority hai aur usko kis priority se usko flow karana hai network mein. Right. Next, payload length. The size of the payload length is of 16 bits. It shows the length of the IPv6 payload including the extension. Next is next header. Next header, it is of 8 bits. It defines the type of services being used like TCP, UDP and protocols. Next is hop limit. Hop limit is similar to the time to live in the IPv4. It is of 8 bits. Next is source address. It is 128, which defines the sender's address. Next is destination address, which is also 128 bit, and it decides the address of the receiver. Next, we are discussing subnetting. What is subnetting? Subnetting is the division of a network into multiple small networks, या फिर subnetworks जिसको हम बोल सकते हैं. Subnetworks who created are called subnets. Why we created the subnets? Because it improved the security of the network and also it helps in the maintenance and administration of the subnets. Like for example, we can understand this from the diagram. Like we have a big network over here and then we performed the subnetting and it was divided into the 4 main parts. Ek diagram se aur aap isko samajh sakte hain. Like we have an internet and we have an IP address 38.9.211.1 and we divided it into three subnets over here. In later part we'll understand how subnetting is performed. Like next, type of subnetting. We have two basic types of subnetting. First is the fixed length subnetting and second is the variable length subnetting. Fixed length is also called classful subnetting and variable length is called classless subnetting. In the fixed length subnetting, fixed length network is divided into subnets where we have same size of the subnets and we have equal number of hosts and also the all subnets have the same subnet mask. While in case of the variable length, we do not have the same size, also we do not have the equal number of hosts and also we do not have the same subnet mask for the all networks. Now we'll understand how subnetting is performed from by an example. Consider an IP address 200.1.2.0 and we need to divide it into the two networks, like okay. So from the IP address we can easily guess that this IP address is of the class C. That means we have 24 bits reserved for the network IDs and last 8 bits for the host ID. So like we have arranged it in the 4 blocks, as I told you, like we divide our address into the 4 blocks in a 32 bit address ya fir IPv4 jo apna hota hai usme, right? So we have arranged it. How subnetting is performed? The subnet ID is created by borrowing some bits from the host ID part of the IP address. जो भी हमारा host ID part होता है IP address का, उसमें से हम कुछ bits borrow करते हैं और उससे हम subnet ID create करते हैं. The number of bits borrowed depend upon the number of the subnets created. That means how many bits we need to borrow from the host ID depends upon the how many subnets we want to create. Like here, the example we are considering, we need to divide our network into the two subnets. So we need only one bit, that is either 0 or 1. We can represent two different networks by either 0 or 1. So we borrow one bit from the host ID. After borrowing, the bits will look like this, like 200.1 and one bit from the 8 bits is reserved for the subnet ID. That will be 0 and 1 and next 7 bits will represent the host ID. So if we borrow 0, it represents the subnet 1 and 1 it represents the second subnet. Then the IP address of the subnets will be 200.1.2.0, which is fixed for the first network and then 00 so on, and then we will convert it into the decimal. Next 200.1.2.1 and then 00s is 200.1.2.128. That means जो हमारा एक आई पी एड्रेस था 200.1.2.0 हमने उसको दो सबनेट्स में डिवाइड कर दिया जिनके सबनेट आई डीज हैं 200.1.2.0 एंड 200.1.2.128, राइट। अब हम बात करेंगे कि फर्स्ट सबनेट में कितने आईपी एड्रेस हो सकते हैं, कितने होस्ट हो सकते हैं। तो आईपी एड्रेस ऑफ दिस सबनेट हमारा ये हमने निकाल ही लिया था, कितने हमारे आईपी एड्रेसेस होंगे 2^7, क्योंकि हमारे पास होस्ट बिट कितनी बची थी 7। ठीक है, टोटल नंबर ऑफ होस्ट कितने होंगे -2, 128, टोटल आईपी एड्रेसेस -2 विच इज 126। टोटल रेंज कितनी हो जाएगी, 0 से सारे जितने भी 7 बिट्स हैं उनको 1 से फिल कर देंगे। जब इसको डेसिमल में कन्वर्ट करेंगे तो कितना जाएगा, 0 to 127। सिमिलरली फॉर द सेकंड सबनेट मास्क, आईपी एड्रेस ऑफ द सबनेट इज 200.1.2.128 एंड टोटल आईपी एड्रेस इज इक्वल टू 2^7, दैट इज 128। टोटल होस्ट एज आई टोल्ड यू बिफोर द टोटल नंबर ऑफ आईपी एड्रेस -2, दैट इज 126। सिमिलरली इसकी रेंज भी हम निकाल सकते हैं, यहाँ पे 1 फिक्स है अपना, बाकी सारे डिजिट्स को 0 से लेकर के लास्ट सारे डिजिट्स को 1, सारे डिजिट्स को 1 से फिल कर देंगे तो टोटल रेंज कितनी हो जाएगी, 128 से 255 तक। दिस इज फॉर द टुडेज क्लास। नेक्स्ट इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल डिस्कस द टाइप ऑफ आईपी एड्रेसेस एंड द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक। थैंक यू सो मच।